Now, there was an interesting moment in the debate where Mitt Romney was going to show that he's a man of courage, that he is going to cut the budget, he's going to take action, it's not just theoretical, and he's willing to take on popular programs, including PBS and including the moderator. Watch.
I'm sorry, Jim. I'm going to stop the subsidy to PBS. I'm going to stop other things. I like PBS. I love Big Bird. Actually, like you too. But I'm not going to keep on spending money on things to borrow money from China to pay for.
All right. My two favorite points in that, of course, is I like you too. It's just a wonderfully condescending Mitt Romney line. And when Jim Lehrer goes,
and I love that they cut to him. Like, oh, we got to see what his face looks like on this.
Right. Now, here's the sense of perspective that you absolutely need. In fact, if I'm the Democrats, I would have done an ad on this. The federal government budget is $3.5 trillion. The Corporation for Public Broadcasting, $444 million. I know it's a funny thing to say, but it's not even $1 billion. The budget is $3.5 trillion. To give you a sense of perspective, what percentage of the budget is it? 0.012% of the budget. So, Mr. Romney, I'm gonna get tough. I'm gonna cut things I need to cut. I'll tell you, I'm gonna cut the 0.012%. Okay, now, we're not done yet. Well, by the way, Big Bird immediately popped up on Twitter.
Oh,
of course!
It's all over Reddit, too.
Right, it's all over everywhere. Here's one tweet from Big Bird immediately. If Romney had grown up with me, he wouldn't have his numbers all screwed up. Big Bird for the win.
Of course, what I wanted Obama desperately to say was, Governor Romney, I knew Big Bird. Big Bird was a friend of mine.
Big Bird. So now, the framing is not just that Corporation for Public Broadcasting is a tiny, tiny part of the budget. It's about priorities. And Mitt Romney's priorities are completely different in his tax plan. 50% of the tax cuts go to the top 5%. 25% of the tax cuts goes to the top 1%. So where's his priorities? Now, it's even more stark when you look at a guy like Sheldon Adelson, who's a big donor to Mitt Romney and to the Republicans. According to Think Progress, they actually have a different branch of it that did these numbers, that crunched the numbers. Sheldon Adelson will receive a $2.3 billion tax break in the 4 years that Mitt Romney would be president if he's elected. $2.3 billion. The heart of that is...
How much money does this guy have?
Over $20 billion.
You know what we should do? We should start a casino.
And maybe put it in, like, China or something. Macau, island.
And one in Nevada. Too.
That's an idea. So now the reason that he would gain so much from the Romney tax plan is Romney does a repatriation tax holiday, which is you can bring your money back and not pay taxes, which is outrageous because you're supposed to be paying 35% taxes. And 90% of Adelson's money is made in Macau, not in Vegas. Only 10% is in Vegas. He can't wait to bring that money back. If Romney gets elected, he can bring it back for almost free. Now, if you think that's bad, the estate tax, Adelson's family, Romney would eliminate the estate tax. Adelson's family would save $8.9 billion. So, now one other fun fact. Corporation for Public Broadcasting funds PBS, but that's not the only thing it funds. PBS is actually a small part of it. PBS only gets $22.3 million a year. That's it. Within the scope of the budget, that is minuscule. But to give you a sense of how much Sheldon Adelson's tax breaks would fund, Corporation for Public Broadcasting would be funded for 25 years just on Adelson's tax breaks, extra tax breaks that Romney would give him, okay? PBS would be funded for nearly 500 years. So when you look at that, you go, oh, I get it. Mitt Romney cares so much more about this one billionaire than he does about Big Bird that he loves so much, and Jim Lehrer that he cares so much for, and PBS and Sesame Street and NPR and all those things combined. That's the sense of priorities that's absolutely wrong with Mitt Romney and that the American people clearly do not agree with.
I think it's, first of all, I wonder how the show would age over 500 years. It'd be interesting to see them like broadcasting from the surface of Mars or something like that. But this is certainly nothing new, the focusing on things like PBS. Every year, not just Republican presidential candidates, but the Senate, the House, they target the National Science Foundation. They target the National Endowment for the Arts. It's always these things that conservatives have sort of a gut instinct, why are we paying for this? I don't like going to look at paintings. Why should I pay for that? but that make up 0.01% of the budget.
But there's one other aspect to it, John. It's not just that, it's artsy-fartsy stuff we don't like. By the way, the Koch brothers loved artsy-fartsy stuff, and they funded a huge building in the Lincoln Center in New York. Where among their rich friends, they get big credit for that, right? Mm-hmm. No, it's mainly to attack points of information. PBS, NPR give out facts, they give out information, and that is the worst enemy of propaganda. So that's why the conservatives always attack media, they attack professors, they attack universities, they attack science, and they attack NPR and PBS, because they view it as competition.
Yeah, I don't understand why, just the fact, one side, say what you will about what's wrong with the Democrats, right? And how much in the,
we
the
do.
How they're maybe in a smaller pocket, but they're in a Wall Street pocket. They're like in the watch pocket, whereas Republicans are like, they're in the meat of the pants, you know?
Right.
But one side says, get up in the morning and read the paper. One side says, go to college, listen to your professor. And one side says, for the love of God, don't. Don't listen. Don't read, don't learn. I mean, that's all there is. And so I'm literally baffled by my grown-up friends who like have chosen to become Republicans. I get the people who grew up with it. I don't understand. One side says learn, and then decide for yourself.
That's the thing my dad's obsessed about. The Rick Santorum line from a couple of weeks ago when he said, we're never going to get smart people on our side. Mm-hmm. What an unbelievable, startling admission. We're the party of dumbasses. And they're kind of proud of it.
I don't even like putting it that way. It's just this, it's this reluctance to learn, the reluctance to have this information.
Rather than being dumb, because you're right, that's a little unfair. It's not exactly the right way to frame it. They are choosing ignorance.
They're choosing ignorance.
And the reason is because they're not right. So, for example, global warming, and I give you a million examples, but on the issue of climate change, they don't have the facts behind them. They don't have the science behind them. So they get paid by the oil companies. So what are they going to do? They're going to say, damn the facts. They're going to attack the facts. They're going to attack science. They're going to attack education because they don't want you to know the facts, because they get paid by the oil companies and they have an agenda. And so that's why they do it.